This could be an interesting start. As we get set to go to Rogers Arena, a couple teams struggling with goal-scoring. Canucks, lately, three-game road trip that saw them go LA, Anaheim, Phoenix, lost all three in regulation and scored just one goal. Kellen Lane, the product of Lake Superior State, making his NHL debut, is going to face off. And it's Westgarth at center ice. So, some interesting matchups here. We have Sestito and McGrattan lined up against each other. Kevin Bieksa had come up and had a word with Westgarth a moment ago. And now Bieksa is going to face off against Westgarth. So the defenseman moves up for the Canucks.
Tortorella at the Vancouver bench is already looking at the Calgary bench.
And here we go. Line brawl to start this game. Westgarth and Bieksa are separated. Sestito and McGrattan back at the blue line. Torts is angry.
Is he ever? He's looking directly at the Calgary Flames bench.
So we got two fights going on. Kevin Bieksa is now with Schmid on the near boards, and it's Westgarth and Lane near the Vancouver blue line. Will Sestito and McGrattan go at it near the Calgary blue line? Welcome to the NHL, Kellen Lane.
Handling himself really well, too, considering his opponent.
Lane is 6'6".
McGrattan just got the best of Sestito.
Meantime, back in the Vancouver end, in front of Roberto Luongo, Weiss and Jones are separated, and looks like cooler heads are about to prevail. But, Kelly, we saw this coming. We got the starting lineups tonight.
No question about it. When you get these kind of guys and you know the rivalry between the two teams, this clearly makes a lot of sense from what we saw with the starting lineups.
So you see Tortorella
still going at it.
And the visiting team submits their lineup and their starting five before the home team does. So Bob Hartley would have given his lineup in, and Tortorella obviously saw who he was starting, fourth line, and matched with his fourth line, and here's what that led to right off the opening faceoff.
We haven't seen a brawl like this in a long time, have we, at the National Hockey League level?
So Westgarth and Bieksa were separated, then Kellen Lane got involved with Westgarth and did pretty well in his first NHL fight.
6'6", Lane, and he's got to make his presence felt. He didn't hesitate to drop him, did he?
So Tortorella still yelling at Bob Hartley, who's not even coming over to engage in the conversation.
Kessler and Hudler.
And now Hartley comes over as some of the Flames have gone towards the photographer's moat between the benches. The Canucks are over there. Burrows in his first game back with the
Shane
protector
O'Brien,
around his broken jaw.
That's normally at the other end of the bench, made his way down by the forwards on the Flames.
And as Tortorella continues to berate Bob Hartley, he is furious.
Well, I wonder what PJ Stock's going to say during the intermission about this.
You know, PJ's loving it.
Yep. Maybe not at the National Hockey League level. You maybe didn't have 5-on-5 brawls, but certainly in the minors you would have had a few.
You're right. Just does not happen anymore at this level. You don't even see it in junior hockey
very often
anymore.
You know, the thing is now for the remaining players, now they have to calm themselves down and just remind themselves to play. And we know Vancouver's been a little bit undisciplined on that three-game road trip, and so again, don't take any penalties. Try and stay in the moment and do your job.
Some of this started for Vancouver in the first game of that trip in LA, and that was the first game since Dustin Brown ran over Luongo.
But that was terrific.
And I was going to say, the Canucks felt really, even though they lost that game, that's what they had to do, establish a physical presence, show the LA Kings they weren't going to get pushed around, and they were more than happy to take all those penalties as a response.
That was a moral victory, that one in Los Angeles, even though they lost. But that's how they came together as a team.
So as they clean up the debris on the ice, and there's some blood back near the Calgary blue line that they're going to have to scrape up as well. This might be a while. We're 2 seconds into this hockey game.